Bonjour tout le monde. I want to start off today by talking about the job report we just received for March. As stark as those numbers are, they aren't a surprise for a lot of Canadians. Each one represents a different story. A worker who's been laid off, a family that's having to hunker down, a community that's anxious about today and tomorrow. We've all seen the impact of COVID-19. We've all knew this was going to be a tough time and that countries around the world are in a similar situation. But that's no comfort if you're out of a job, if you're having difficulty making ends meet. You need real support. So we're doing our best to help you bridge to better times. On Monday, we launched the Canada Emergency Response Benefit. More than 4.5 million claims have been processed, which means people are already receiving their $2,000 for this month. We're also working on legislation to bring in a wage subsidy to help employers keep people on the payroll while working on new loans for business owners. We will keep expanding our three-point economic plan to protect jobs, support business owners, and get everyone the help they need. Things will get better, and once they do, you can be sure that our country will come roaring back. As a country, we've gotten through tough times before. We've stood together, united and strong. On Vimy Ridge, more than 100 years ago today, thousands of Canadians gave their lives so that our country would know peace. Aujourd'hui, nous nous souvenons de ceux qui sont tombés à Vimy, il y a plus de 100 ans aujourd'hui. On se souvient des sacrifices qu'ils ont faits pour notre pays. Ils se sont battus pour défendre les valeurs qui sont chères, comme la démocratie, la liberté, l'égalité, pour les valeurs qui définissent encore notre pays. As historians have noted, reflecting on Vimy, it was a moment ordinary people did extraordinary things. Fathers and sons, brothers and friends, their sacrifice and courage defined what it is and what it meant to be a Canadian. And their legacy lives on in the women and men who continue to step up and serve us in uniform, in our nurses and doctors who put themselves in harm's way for us all to stay healthy, and in everyone who steps up and asks what they can do for their fellow Canadians. That's what makes Canada strong, and that will be our path forward, no matter what tomorrow may bring. Right now, the future can seem even more uncertain than normal. If you've lost your job, if you're worried about an elderly parent, you probably want to know what to expect. Earlier today, we released our modelling on how we think this pandemic might unfold. The modelling shows that COVID-19 arrived in Canada later than in other countries. So we're in an earlier stage of the outbreak. That means we have the chance to determine what our country looks like in the weeks and months to come. Our healthcare systems across the country are coping for the time being. But we're at a fork in the road between the best and the worst possible outcomes. The best possible outcome is no easy path for any of us. The initial peak, the top of the curve, may be in late spring with the end of the first wave in the summer. As Dr. Tam explained, there will likely be smaller outbreaks for a number of months after that. This will be the new normal until a vaccine is developed. But as we saw, that is so much better than we could face all of us if we do not rise to the challenge of this generation. The path we take is up to us. It depends on what each of us does right now. It will take months of continued determined effort. We'll need to keep practicing physical distancing, staying home, and washing our hands. It will help. It will help get the numbers that Dr. Tam was talking about, between 4,000 and 44,000 deaths as low as possible. Je sais que la Dr. Tam et toute l'équipe de l'Agence de la Santé publique ont travaillé très fort pour préparer ces prévisions. Et pour nous assurer que toutes les informations sont à jour, nous avons été en communication constante avec les provinces et les territoires pour obtenir leurs dernières données. Plus tôt aujourd'hui, nous avons dévoilé nos projections. Les modèles démontrent que la COVID-19 est arrivée au Canada plus tard que dans d'autres pays, donc on est à un stade plus précoce de l'épidémie. Ça veut dire que nos gestes ont encore plus d'importance pour décider à quoi notre pays va ressembler dans les semaines et dans les mois à venir. Pour l'instant, nos systèmes de santé tiennent le coup, mais on est à la croisée des chemins. La route qui va nous mener aux meilleurs résultats ne sera pas facile. On pourrait atteindre le sommet de la courbe à la fin du printemps et la première vague pourrait se terminer pendant l'été. Mais comme la Dr. Tam l'a expliqué, on va probablement connaître d'autres vagues d'infection moins importantes pendant un certain nombre de mois. C'est notre et ce sera notre nouvelle réalité jusqu'à ce qu'on trouve un vaccin. Mais comme on l'a vu ce matin, c'est le meilleur scénario que ce qui pourrait se produire si on refusait d'agir. La route qu'on va prendre dépend entièrement de nous tous. Il va falloir être discipliné pendant les prochains mois. On va devoir continuer à rester chez nous et continuer à nous laver les mains. C'est comme ça qu'on va éviter des milliers de décès et qu'on va réduire le nombre de cas. I know it's tough to stay home, especially as the weather gets nicer. If you have kids, it's even tougher. But to get them back outside and running around the playground and park as soon as possible, you need to keep them inside for a little longer. This will work, and we'll be with you every step of the way. Just this week, we received millions more masks to keep our frontline workers safe, and we have contracts to get more ventilators. We're helping industry mobilize, like the entrepreneur from VARS, Ontario, who's creating reusable visors for hospitals across the province. And we've continued to support Canadian researchers working on a vaccine. We're pulling out all the stops to beat this virus and help you get through this time. On doit tous faire notre part, les gouvernements, les entreprises et les citoyens. Donc, continuez de rester chez vous. Allez faire votre épicerie une fois par semaine et seulement, une fois par semaine seulement, ou encore moins seulement, moins souvent. Et si vous devez sortir, gardez 2 mètres de distance entre vous et les autres. C'est comme ça qu'on va protéger les personnes vulnérables. C'est comme ça qu'on va protéger nos aînés. C'est comme ça qu'on va sauver des vies. Et c'est comme ça qu'on va aider nos infirmières et nos médecins qui font un travail extraordinaire à chaque jour. Je sais que ce n'est pas facile, mais ce n'est pas pour toujours. Éventuellement, on va pouvoir retourner au cinéma, au restaurant et au parc. Mais pour ça, tout le monde doit faire sa part maintenant et pour les semaines à venir. Over 100 years ago today, Canadians showed what metal we are made of. I know each of us will rise to be worthy of the legacy of the heroes that built this country. We can do this together. Merci tout le monde.